If you've just purchased a Babyface Pro FS, congratulations on making a great choice. You now own one of the most respected compact audio interfaces in the world, engineered in Germany for reliability, longevity, and pristine sound quality. In this video, I'm going to take you through all of the basics that you need to know, including an overview of the unit itself, installing drivers and software, connecting everything up, and finally, the basics of RME's powerful total mix effects. So don't worry if you're not familiar with RME or audio interfaces in general. We're going to go through everything step by step in an easy to understand manner. Let's get started by looking at the unit itself. On the top are your main controls, the rotary encoder, a number of buttons, and a set of LED meters showing levels and settings. These let you adjust mic gain, monitor levels, and adjust key features directly from your hardware. We'll come back to these controls later in the video and look at how to use them in more detail. On the right side are your instrument and headphone connections. Inputs 3 and 4 accept quarter-inch jacks, perfect for guitars, keyboards, and other line sources. Then you've got two headphone outputs, a standard quarter-inch jack and a mini jack. You'll also notice here the Kensington lock slot for theft protection. On the back panel, you'll find your main balanced XLR connectors. Inputs 1 and 2 for microphones or line level sources, and outputs 1 and 2 for your studio monitors. RME's digitally controlled preamps provide excellent headroom and extremely low noise, and we'll see how to adjust their gain later on. On the left side, you'll find the optical inputs and outputs, which can work as ADAT or SPDIF. The 6-pin mini DIN can be used with the supplied breakout cable for MIDI in and out. There's a USB 2 connection for your computer also. The Babyface Pro FS is bus powered in most situations, meaning you can power it directly from your computer's USB port. However, there is also a locking DC power connection for use with an optional RME DC power supply. On the base, we find a 3/8 inch thread, so we can attach the unit to a stand. There's also a small recess slide switch that changes the maximum output level of the XLR outs. It's set to +19 dBU by default, but switching it to +4 dBU is ideal for sensitive powered monitors. Don't worry, you'll only ever have to set this once. Now that we're familiar with the hardware, let's install the software. Head to the RME website and go to the download section. Select the Babyface Pro FS as your device, then select your operating system, followed by driver. Mac users can choose between two driver systems. The classic kernel extension driver offers the full feature set and supports Intel and older macOS versions. The newer driver kit version is Apple's modern secure framework required on the latest macOS releases. Whichever you choose, both deliver the same high-performance RME experience. After download, I'd highly recommend reading the installation instructions for your Mac version. For Windows users, simply select the driver suitable for your version of Windows. In all cases, I'd recommend restarting your computer so the driver can register correctly. Once this is done, let's proceed to the hardware setup. So let's get everything connected. I'll walk you through the basics so you can be recording in no time. Start by connecting the supplied USB cable directly to your computer. Avoid hubs where possible for best performance. You'll find cables included with both Type A and Type C connectors, so use the most suitable one for your computer. Plug your microphones into XLR inputs 1 or 2 and your monitors into the XLR outputs on the back. Plug any instruments into inputs 3 or 4 and your headphones into either of the two outputs. Now that everything's connected, let's see how to control it, first from the hardware, then from the software. Previously, we saw the rotary encoder and buttons. Now let's learn the basics of how to use them with the interface connected to the computer. Let's start with inputs. Repeatedly press in to select an input pair. Now press the select button repeatedly to switch between left, right, or both channels. Once selected, use the encoder to adjust that channel's input gain. To adjust its mix level, press the mix button and then adjust the encoder. Similarly for output, repeatedly press the out button to select an output and use the encoder to adjust its level. Holding select while moving the encoder in this mode adjusts panning for that output. And finally, pressing dim toggles dimming for the main output. All of these settings are reflected inside Total Mix Effects, so let's head over there next. Total Mix Effects has two routing modes, submix and free. To get started, we'll just focus on the submix mode. You can see here there are three rows of faders. The top row is for hardware inputs, so things like microphone and instrument inputs, as well as digital inputs. The second row is for software playback, and this is typically going to be output from your DAW. And finally, the third row is for hardware outputs, so things like your main monitor outputs, headphone outputs, and digital outputs as well. Let's now focus on the hardware inputs. Before we adjust any faders at all, we'll need to take care of some basic settings for any channels we wish to record with. We do that by going to the channel in question and then clicking on the tool icon to reveal the settings panel for that channel. Here we can do things like turn on phantom power for any microphones that require it. And of course, we'll want to go ahead and set our input gain. Once we're happy with the levels that we're getting here, then we can go ahead and use this source in our mix. Now it's important to understand that every single output can have its own mix. Therefore, before we create a mix, we need to start by selecting that output. I want to create a mix for my headphones, so I'm going to go ahead and select my headphone output before I adjust any other faders. Now by default, the stereo output from our DAW is routed to analog 1 and 2 on our software playback row. Now I don't want to hear my DAW for the moment, so I'm going to adjust the fader all the way down to the bottom for that channel. Because I want to start off by hearing the input of a guitar that I'm recording on analog channel 1. So to hear that guitar, I'll just push this fader up like so. Now once I'm happy with the level of that guitar, I may want to also hear a vocal that I'm recording on channel 2. So again, I'll go ahead and push the fader up for that channel. And now that I'm happy with the balance between those two channels, I'm going to go ahead and push the fader up for the DAW. I should have known it from the start. And that's the basics for creating any mix in Total Mix Effects. You're now fully set up and ready to create with your Babyface Pro FS. You've seen the hardware, learned some of the controls, installed the drivers and software, and gotten started with the powerful Total Mix Effects. There's more to explore when you're ready, but even with these basics, you can get world-class results. Thank you for watching and enjoy recording with your Babyface Pro FS.